described and captioned media program. In the classroom and on the go. DCMP.org.
Annenberg presents Organizing Atoms and Electrons, the Periodic Table.
Basically, the periodic table is our lifeline.
As a chemist, I use the periodic table on a daily basis. All chemists would find useful information in the periodic table.
And now we're going to react potassium with water.
A bit of metal is dropped into water and it flames before bursting into smoke.
The elements are the basic building blocks of the universe, and the periodic table orders them in a very clever way. But the periodic table, contrary to what you might believe, isn't set in stone.
It is an extraordinary achievement that nearly 118 elements, either naturally occurring or synthesized, have been identified so far. Many elements have been known for millennia, but scientists continue to isolate new ones today.
We're looking at the periodic table and we're saying, should be right there, and then actually, maybe it is, maybe it isn't. So it's a big guessing game until you actually produce it.
We're trying to fill in the blanks, and we're also trying to figure out how many more blanks there are.
The Described and Captioned Media Program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deafblind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a set of guidelines for adding descriptions and captions to media. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.